I said in September 2008, when this first recent crash became clear, that there was a three-step game going on here. The first step was to crash the economy so that people could see there was a problem. The next stage was to get governments to empty their barrels, if you like, to empty their ability to respond to it financially by hurling enormous, fantastic cuckoo land amounts of money at the banking system, which was designed from the start to disappear, which, of course, the vast majority of it has. And the third stage, which I'm now waiting for, is when they make the judgment that it's optimum moment, they crash the economy again in a way that governments have no longer any means of responding to it, even in the ludicrous way they did in the last couple of years. And then the banking system itself will be stepping forward as the savior, and they'll say the only way of sorting out this global mess is ABCD, and it will be a global economic tyranny based on a world central bank in which a few people sitting around one table will dictate finance to every country. This, of course, is where we've been going all along. You know, if there's a few of you, and compared with the 7 billion we're supposed to have on this planet, it is an absolute tiny few that are in full awareness behind this conspiracy. And if they are going to reach their goal of a fully fledged global dictatorship, then they have to incessantly centralize power. And the more power they have, the more power they have over more and more people. And the more power they have centrally, the more power they have to then centralize even quicker. And this is why the speed of globalization in all areas of our lives has got faster and faster. And of course, the Rockefeller Rothschild World Trade Organization is there to ensure that countries cannot defend themselves against the merciless world system, so that every country is dependent on forces and events that are outside their sphere of influence and outside their sphere of control and response. And this is the whole idea, to get everyone dependent on everyone else, so that the few people at the center running this system have power over every area of our lives. I was talking to a journalist yesterday in England, a mainstream journalist, who was like saying he's seeing it. The centralization of power in the media is now blatant, and we're now reaching that point I talked about 15 years ago, where the agenda that for decade after decade, indeed century after century, has operated in the shadows, there comes a point where it has to break the surface when it's getting close to its final goal, but close to introducing the new world it wants to. Well, that new world is eventually going to break the surface where we can actually see it. It has to, otherwise it can't become the new world. And we're now at that point, and this is why we have a tremendous challenge, but tremendous opportunity. Because it's becoming so blatant, more and more people are seeing what they couldn't see before. So it's a real fork in the road we're facing here. But we have reached this amazing point where people are finding, even those with their head in the sand. By the way, to have your head in the sand, you have to be on your knees, and the two things go together. And it's time we got off our knees. And to do that, first of all, we've got to get our heads out of the bloody sand and actually face what we're dealing with here. And we're at this amazing point now where they can't hide it anymore, and humanity is faced with a choice that will be more and more difficult for it to persuade itself and kid itself that there's not a choice to be made, because it's really not happening. It's just conspiracy theory. No, this is in our face now. So we're entering very fast, Alex, a totally new phase in this game, in this unfolding conspiracy to impose a global fascist communist state, because they're both masks on the same face anyway. And for me, we are are going to continue to go down this road for some years yet, where it seems that this control system is going incessantly in the direction it wants to and is unstoppable. But I am absolutely convinced that in the years between 2016 to 2020, that period, then there is going to be enough people who have awoken to this and can see this, there's going to come a tipping point. And they are trying to, what they've been trying to do all these years is to bring in the surveillance, the control, the data surveillance, the surveillance of where you go on the internet, surveillance of every area of your life, to bring in the more and more the militarization of law enforcement, even domestic law enforcement. It's happening all over the world. While they've, of course, been using terrorists as the excuse and terrorism as the excuse, we well know that what it's really been constructed for and constantly added to for is the population, the general population. That's what it's for. And it's not even for the population that will stay asleep or go into a freeze mode through fear of what they're seeing. It's for those people who are waking up, and it's for those people who are prepared to do something. And so, it's so important for people to appreciate that this is not made up by the day or the month or the week or the year or even the decade. This has been long projected forward. And so all the different elements of it, the understanding of what they're going to do in terms of the economic crash, et cetera, the way that's going to be received by the public, we're seeing it now, more and more unrest, et cetera. And a parallel to that, another wing of this conspiracy has been preparing for this with the excuse of terrorism to bring in all these anti-terrorist laws and all these institutions